Hey Tumblr's coaches, just wanted to do a quick overview of the lesson plan for the next 3 weeks, give it a little tips and pointers, and feel free to send questions afterwards. So we're going to start in area one. Again, we're starting with bounding. This is how I have it set up this time. I thought it might be better if it's further away from where the other group is doing theirs. If I were leading this, I would have them stand on the blue line facing the mats, then bound down, and then stay on the blue line again. I would probably have them do everything next in the lesson plan off the side towards the blue line, so you could have them line up on the side near the wall and then walk around the mat and do the exercise over here so that nobody feels like they're getting too close to the wall. Then the stations are the run and jump off the springboard, backward roll down the cheese mat, and the trapezoid handstand. The trapezoid handstand, make sure to watch the video. That's super helpful, I think. And then you guys know what a jump tuck to handstand and jump straddle to handstand is, so feel free to challenge kids in those ways. And please show the stations. I think it makes a big difference when they're seeing what it's supposed to look like. Then for the cheese mat, remember we want to be teaching them to push both hands on the floor. So they should be using their hands, and that prevents them from going crooked. There's a really helpful picture there that shows that exactly step by step. We often call that pizza hands. So you have them stand and hold their hands next to their shoulders, like if they were carrying two pizzas, and then they sit down and smush their pizzas into the floor. The main focus on the springboard is jumping to stick, finish, soldier. So it should not look like a huge relay race with kids running and jumping and running and jumping in circles. So you might have to stand where I am right now and stick with them, finish with them, and soldier with them. And then you can challenge them or mix it up by doing tucks, straights, and straddles. But make sure that they're stopping moving at the end of each, because that's the main focus of what we're trying to do here. They should also be going from 1 foot on the panel mat to 2 feet on the springboard and add an arm circle if you're able. But more than anything, stick, finish, soldier. Here's how I would set up the area two warm up. So each of these dots has a matching color on the other side, and that gives them a clear place where they need to get to before they can turn around. I would start the kids on these dots and put two kids at each color, then have a child go down to the other dot and back with whichever exercise, and then let their partner go down and back. So there should always be five kids doing activity and then five kids resting to make sure that they're not standing still for too long during class. Remember, we can only expect so much from some of these kids as far as what they'll be able to pay attention to, and standing in a line of more than three people is not really reasonable for most of these kids who are inexperienced gymnasts and not the best learners yet. Then we'll go over to the area two stations. On the high beam, we're walking backwards today. Most kids will shuffle their feet backwards, and what you really want to focus on is that they're going 1 foot behind the other. If they're able to do that, you could add arms, you could add releve, but we want them going one step behind the other. A lot of kids get to the end of the resi, and the scary part is going across that canyon before they get to the maroon one. And if that's the case, you can have them dismounting onto the yellow line on the blue resi instead of the end if you're unable to stand there. So it's really not worth getting kids upset or having them cry. I don't know what kind of experience you're having yet, but I would just say dismount onto the blue mat as needed. There's also the picture there still of mounting the beam, and make sure you're taking the time for them to learn that correctly. Then over on the red pad, we're doing teeter totter. Remember, this is the lead up to handstand, and there's so much you can coach about it. When kids get into competition, they compete that for a year often. So don't overlook it or let kids think it's not important, because it is. Then here we're practicing a kick to handstand. Now most kids will need to start position on the floor, put their hands up on the squishy mat, and kick as high as they can. Then for the 9 to 11 class, you could have them handstand flatback, handstand bridge. If you want to, you could even have them move their hands down to the harder mat then and bridge up to the 8-inch and kick back over. But we also want to be making sure that we're challenging kids to get to a straight handstand and being able to hold it, not always just going past that to try for the next thing. If they can't kick to a good handstand, then they shouldn't be doing a kick over anyways. Then on the laser beam is working on kicks forwards. If they need a challenge, you could add arms, you could add releve, any of those things. But just remember, you've done kicks forwards a million times. So don't let kids rush through it, and make sure that they're being coached at it. Then over on area three, this is how I would have it set for warm up. So the bar will be at this height for you. It's a notch lower than I left it last time, but this also might be kind of high for some of the 5 and 6 year olds to do jump to front support. So you might need to pull this 8 inch over to that bar to put the block on if it's not the right fit for your kids. That's where you want them to be doing jump to front support from the block, then going to the end of their line, then pull the block back so they're standing on the floor, and try and teach them a chin hang, tuck hang. So chin above the bar and hold their knees up, then have them try jump to front support, finish in a forward roll chin hang. And then they would turn around to this side of the bar where I'm standing, put their hands on the bar and walk their feet on the block and try and kick over for a pullover. This is gonna be really hard for some kids, but some kids need to be trying it. The block will move when they kick on it, so their partner should be holding it still from the other side. The block should be a little bit farther out than it is right now, but those blocks are gonna have to move in and out throughout warm-up as it is. I also think after warm-up is done, that this bar should turn into the spider hang station. So this bar will not be used because it's still being used for bat hang for preschool. So spider hang should be here, and there's a picture down in the corner of the screen right now so you can show kids what that looks like. Please watch the video on YouTube of how to challenge kids differently on their spider hang. The other station should be pull-ups, which is set up over here. So you can see how they should put their hands on the bar, then walk their feet on top of the block so their body weight is much less, and then try to bend their arms to pull their chin above the bar. So this might be an area where you might need to spot some kids so that they can experience a pull-up if they're not able to lift their own body weight. You can also have them repeat that chin hang that they learned during warm-up, where they pull their chin up and kind of stand on the blocks and just work on keeping their arms bent. Kids are at very, very different levels for this, so you just need to find the way to challenge the kids that you're working with the most. If it's easy for a kid, I would say have them try and do a pull-up with their legs in an L, so lifting their whole body off. And some kids are that strong and do need to be challenged like that. Or of course, you could always have them do more pull-ups in a row. And then the last station is monkey walk, which I have set up like this. I pulled the 8 inch under because I think for 5 and 6 class you will need it, and for the other ages you will have to pull it out. So what you want is them to be able to hang as close to a straight body as they can and grab on where the red block is, and then scooch their hands sideways across the bar as far over as is comfortable, and then drop down to a stick position so that they're doing a full hang on the bar and learning to transfer their weight and move across the bar. So when they do that, often they kind of look like they're swinging side to side because they're moving their weight from one hand to the other. This is also one where some kids have trouble and we might need to spot them at first, and some kids will think it's really easy, and that's when we need to challenge them to keep their legs together, hold their knees up in a tuck or an L, make sure that one time their left hand leads and the next time their right hand leads because they might have a stronger one. And I've even had some kids go monkey walk all the way across and then all the way back to the red block in one turn because they just need to be hanging onto the bar longer. So you guys, I think, will get a better feel for how to challenge kids once you've started coaching that one. You guys are doing an awesome job. Thank you. Talk to you soon. Bye.